Today, I'm going to fast read as I can. Chapter 1, page 1 of the classic Oliver Twist. I hope you enjoy. Among other public buildings in a certain town, for which for many reasons it would be prudent to refrain from mentioning it, to which while I assign no fictitious name, there is only one that you come into the most towns, work it or small, to wait a workhouse. And this workhouse was born on a day and a day which I need not trouble myself for opinion as much as it could be of no possible consequence to the reader in the state of the business at all events. But immortality, whose name is prefixed to the head of this chapter, for a long time after it was uttered to this world, sorrow and trouble, but a fair surgeon, it made a matter of considerable doubt whether the child would survive to bear any name at all, in which case it is somewhat more the probable that these warbirds would ever appear, or if they had that being compromised within a couple of pages that would have been possessed the inestimable merit of being the most concise and faithful specimen of biography extended the literature of any country or country. Although I am not disposed to maintain that the being born in workhouse it is itself the most fortunate by all circumstances that possibly could befall a human being, I do mean to say that in this particular instance that it was the best of Oliver Twist that could be possibly to have occurred. The fact is that there has been considerable difference in producing Oliver to take upon itself the most office of respiration, troublesome practice by which custom has rendered necessary to our easy extensive principle for starting to lay gasping on a low clock mattress. Whether or not we pose between this world and the next, the balance be decidedly in favor of the latter. Now, during the brief period, all of this were by grateful grant.